Hi everyone, and welcome to another session, React Call 8 of the certificate course on the climate change crisis, organized by the Asian Pacific Alliances of YMCA and coordinated by the YMCA of Vellore. And I'm Franklin Christopher, the course mentor. So it's going to be a beautiful day today. We have a special guest, Ms. Kiran Pavaskar, who is going to lead us into an interactive session on the topic, the power and effectiveness of theater arts in conveying powerful messages, right? And we are very much curious, Kiran. Let me start with the World Environment Day, which we celebrated yesterday. And today, coincidentally, is YMCA Day. It's the YMCA founding day, right? So a little bit about YMCA, which I took from the Wikipedia, right? So you can also just Google for YMCA and you'll have this detail. So YMCA is celebrating its 176th year of birthday, right? And that's big. And thank you for being a part of it. And we are also thankful for all the previous leaders who have made this happen. According to the wiki page, YMCA is across 120 countries with a total beneficiary of almost 64 million people, right? And so this 120 countries is kind of split into different regions, as Europe, Asia Pacific, the Middle East, Africa, Latin America, Caribbean, United States, and Canada, right? So now we come under the Asia Pacific region, right? So that is what is APAY 2, Asian Pacific Alliances of YMCA, and all this together forms the World Alliances of YMCA, right? So on right on this very same day in the year 1844, Sir George Williams founded YMCA in London. So for a little story of how it started, if you can just see the year 1844, it is the years in which we had the Industrial Revolution kind of declining. It was the end of the Industrial Revolution, right? So George Williams was also working there, and he saw like a lot of people, a lot of youngsters, especially the youth, getting into the non-productive ways, you know, getting to the wrong ways, getting addicted to drugs, alcohol, and adultery, prostitution, and stuff. So he wanted to bring them into a right way, and he founded YMCA for this very own purpose, right? And YMCA has many credits after that. It's been aligned to various universities, various international organizations in enriching the youth and empowering the youth. Even the beautiful sports of basketball, futsal, and racquetball, volleyball, all these were invented as part of YMCA too. Guys, that's a pretty much very, very short story of YMCA, which has a vast stories associated from the last 176 years, right? So I welcome you all again. And about the World Environment Day, I hope you all observed it yesterday, right? So we are at a very crucial point in the time of human history where the climatic conditions, where the environmental conditions are going very haphazard. So we are in a dire need to act. So let's jump into the session for today, right? So we have here Ms. Kiran Pavaskar, right? So Kiran, we welcome you. Before I hand over the mic to you, right, I would like to show a little of your photos here, guys. Let me introduce Kiran to you all. So Kiran is a stage artist. She is a director who has directed a lot of dramas. She is a resident in Mumbai, if I'm right. Correct, Kiran? Right? So, and she is a faculty at MIT School of Drama. And she is also the co-founder of Kirdar Arts Foundation and is also the ambassador of India's youth theatre arts and culture to the world. It's a pleasure to have you, Kiran. And thank you so much for accepting our invitation and to kind of enlighten us with the power of creativity and the power of theater arts to convey powerful messages, right? And we have seen over the history the impact of arts, like arts, to a greater extent, right?
It's always been the bridge between the past, present, and the future.
And played an important role in addressing a lot of social issues, right? I would just like to mention one Tamil movie here, which is called Parashakti, right? And it is it is written by our former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Kalinir, right? And I encourage you all to go watch the movie. It speaks a lot about social issues, a lot about social rights. It also speaks about the rights for beggars. And it is the only movie, I could say, till a very long time, that where women is the most brilliant in the movie, right? The hero is a scared character. He is afraid. He is very suicidal. But the woman who comes there, she is very brave. She is very intellectual, right? And it is a beautiful story written. And it was almost in the year 1940s or somewhere, right? So art has always played its importance and has given its contribution to change, you know, the societal thoughts, right? So Kiran, we're looking forward to your session. I now hand over the mic to you.
Hello, everybody. This is Kiran Pavaskar from Mumbai, India. Namaskar. And yes, you lovely people, can you just switch on your videos for a while? Everybody with their bright, beautiful faces. Come on, you can do better. Superb. Amazing. What a lovely audience at 5 p.m. in India. I guess we are all round from the globe, right? Three countries, different time zones. Superb. So let me ask you one question. Just raise your hands if you have a yes, and if you have not, don't raise your hands. Okay, just one question before starting. Have you ever watched a play? A play. Okay. Banana, yes. Franklin, yes. Raksha. Okay, Adrita. Okay. How many of you have never in your life have watched a play or a street play even? Like never watched a play. Never. Oh my God. Hari. Am I right? Okay. I guess after this session, you might love to watch a play. Like definitely. Let's start with the session without wasting any other time. And happy World Environment Day. Once again, it's every day, it's the environment. So share screen, is it? Am I? Yeah, thank you. So Frank had invited me, I guess 20 to 25 days ago, 20 days back, we had a short talk over Instagram. This is the first e-meet with you as well as with him. And it's lovely meeting you all. And I'm a theater artist from Mumbai, and also globally, I have traveled a lot and exchanged ideas, and we have worked together with a lot of lovely, lovely artists from all over the world. And I was fortunate enough to travel and know their stories and what they are doing. So yeah, arts, science, community, technology, everything is going really together. And this is having a powerful impact on each one of us, on every society all over the world. So yeah, the power of theater and arts, specifically of theater and arts, in effectiveness to convey powerful messages. And it's about, I was told to talk specifically about climate change crisis and global justice issues. Oh my God, these are so big names, like such big names. Right, let's go ahead. Select one word from the written words, okay? Okay. So what image does it strike? What does the word create in your mind? Do you have a memory, an incident, article, project, social media, what does it, would you like to share, anybody?
Well, my name is Ismatullah Khaybar, and originally I'm from Afghanistan, but currently I'm doing my master in Indonesia in environmental management. So it's pleasure to joining you for this nice meeting. I selected two different words. What is first one is the change, and the Second one is the evidence. So as we are seeing some evidence now from the nature with different perspectives and pictures, for example, coronavirus, COVID-19, and it all needs and bring us the lessons, the texts, the messages to tell us what should we change in our lifestyle and to bring a big hope for our future, for the next generation of our planet Earth.
Thank you, Khaibar, of those lovely words. And yes, we are changing. And the speed we are changing, we need to reflect on many things. And that was really a thought to give in. So rest of you, can you just write in one line about your memory, about whatever you just thought about the word? Just one line, then we can move ahead. So do you think, I need a thumbs up, do you think theater and performing arts in education is important and also acts as a pillar that holds the community together, or So I need a thumbs up quick. Do you think theater and performing arts is important for our education right now? Everybody. Yes. Yes. Now, the second half of the question is it dying or acts just like another part of entertainment? Now keep this question in your mind. Okay. Just keep this question in your mind. Just keep the second half in your mind. Let's go ahead. So according to Wikipedia, which is a very thoughtful source, as we see, has elaborated theater in a definition, okay? So this is what Wikipedia says. Now, this is something that I partially deny. It's something more than that. Today, I really want to talk about it. So this picture is from India-Pakistan partition, 1947. This picture was taken during the 1947 India-Pakistan partition. You can see a couple of dead bodies which are lying notice and experience this picture. It's from a source from the internet. So this is our play called Poshida. Okay, that we reflected on from this. Is this present situation something like this? We're talking, but are people listening? I'll give you a close-up of the actors. We faced some of the disastrous situations all over the world. During partition, during the Vietnamese war, during a lot of things that happened all around the world. And we were speaking, we were talking. Theater artists from all over the world, performers were acting, they were talking, they were like speaking their hearts out. Why theater? Why theater is important even today? Why doesn't it die? Very simple reason. No heavy production cost. Theater can happen anywhere. Anywhere. It can happen in your house. It can happen even right now. It doesn't need any space. It doesn't need money to start. It needs people or just one person with an idea and a desire to just go ahead and talk about things. He's a storyteller, basically. So yes, we are storytellers. And we tell stories from the society of the society and in and around us. Theater during World War I. Let's go back. Was theater we were talking about global justice, global issues. There had been a lot of global issues all over the years. One of them that I picked is theater during World War One or after World War One? Yes, it was. It was there. It was happening. General public wanted to escape. So yes, theater was there for them. While serving the country, soldiers were treated to performances. Obviously, you can't just fight day and night for nothing. So their psychological health was also being treated by performances. So using whatever they had. Some of the soldiers also formed their own troops. One of them was Balmolars. There was a show called Choo Chin Chow, which was opened at His Majesty's Theater on 3rd August. And it was on Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves. A lot of my friends from the Middle East would know about this story. And yes, it had gained a lot of funds, and it was a great musical at that time. And there were also actors who were fighting for the war, and there were a lot of things going on. So yes, theater was even there during the worst of the times. Now, why am I talking about the past? Why don't I just, you can see the queue in 1947 for the show Choo Chin Chow. So why am I talking about theater that has been already done and the things that have already happened, like the partition, the world war, and things like that? Why? Because we are going through a similar situation right now, and we are not able to see and comprehend the same. This is Syria. Okay. This is from a source from the internet. TRT, if I'm not wrong. And yeah, this is all been devastated. The present condition, even after 100 years. I'm talking about nearly 100 years after World War One. And this is Syria again, and there is a puppeteer, there is a theater artist, and there are a bunch full of kids who are being entertained in the debris. So theater sustains. Theater still sustains. It's not going on anywhere, and it is creating powerful messages. It is like you can just view the image right now and comprehend for your own.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So as you can see, there are a lot of things that we do in theater. There are street plays, there are proscenium, theater in proscenium, theater in education with kids. And there are a lot of lovely things. So how does it convey really powerful message? Do it. Okay. There are a lot of things right now as well. There are issues every day. Each one of us in your country, in your society, you can see a lot of issues. I don't need to really update you on this. This is the coronavirus situation. Apart from China, a lot of countries that have been affected till now. Yeah, we are definitely not going to stop. As artists, we can't definitely stop a cyclone, an oil spill, or we can stop border issues just like this. Just like a quick, okay. But we can create a long-term human impact. Yes, as artists, we dare to create a long-term human impact. Please underline statement in your head.
We are talking about how theater, how we can spread awareness about climate change with the help of theater, right? And you are a thespian, that's what I wanted to know from you. Like, how do you think that is going to happen? Like I'll just give you an example. Very recently, I did this street play on animal cruelty in our university, and
I know how that affected. But like when you talk about climate change, that's such a vast topic. I do not understand how we can, how do you propose that we do a play about it? I'll talk mainly about street play here because like you say, that is more, I feel that is the, you know, that is a better way of communicating with the ordinary people who do not really watch theater that much, but we actually need to go on streets and do it. So how do you think we can talk about climate change or spread awareness regarding these environmental issues using street plays?
Right,
lovely question, Adrita. Okay, yeah. We had done a play, I had done a play with an artist called Dhanendra Kavde. And he's from Balaghat, MP. That is Madhya Pradesh in India. Okay. So we together had done a play called Gittu Girgit. Now Girgit, okay, means chameleon. Okay. Chameleon who changes color. Okay. So we had, the whole play was on global warming. And we had to do it for kids. And we had to make kids understand a vast topic of global warming. How would we do it? The kids were ranging from 6 years and above. Okay? 6 years and above. A vast topic like global warming. How would you understand? Obviously not through test books. Obviously. We can't do it. So our whole play talked about colors. Our hope, because that's the thing that they know. They understand blue. Blue is for rain. So we had blue, we had green, the entire play was about colors, and each color was for a different, it had a different, blue was for rain. So there was a character of rain. Yellow was for sun. So the sun was yellow. And all the entire play was the costumes, the makeup, the set, the property, everything was made out of plastic bottles. Everything was made up of waste materials, and it was lovely. The kids really enjoyed. We had a post-play quick Q&A thing with the kids, wherein the kids could understand, oh, wow, this is plastic. Oh, we can do the same at our school. We can do, I can tell my mommy to collect all the plastic kachra that she has in her waste, that she has in her kitchen, and then I can do something about it. So yes, the school was into it. The children were into it. And then we had performed this play in different schools, through different NGOs, through different institutions. And this is how a big topic that you just called a big topic like global warming was so small for those kids, and each kids, everyone, a tree in India, or in Hindi, that's our national language in India, is called ped. Okay, and for small kids to make it feel really similar, we call it pedu. Okay, so tree was called pedu, and we used to give small tree plants to each kid as a gift after the performance, because they watched a play about global warming, and then they had to do their part to plant that tree. So I think this was something, this play was something more than what it just had to do with colors. It just had to do with some costumes. I would show you one picture I have added in my presentation. I guess, Adrita, I have answered your question a little. Is it?
Yeah. Thanks.
It was in the next slide. Yeah, you can see the left side, the two images. We have built the entire costume, the stage. It's everything is from waste. And on the right side, it talks about water, saving water. And this play is strictly for 2 years, small kids for 2 years. It's a silent play. And it talks about saving water. How can we save water? How does a small kid, just a two-year kid, understand about saving water? You can make them understand through a lot of different things. You just don't have to make them watch a movie, or you have to sit them and make them understand, oh, don't close the tap or close this. There are so many different ways to educate our future. So yeah, these are the two important plays that I really wanted to talk about for advocating very powerful messages to kids as small as 2 years, to kids as small as 6, 7, 8 years or 10 years, because this is our future and we have to really, really, really think about how we are going to save them, how we are going to make them understand, okay, this is the situation, how will you react on the same? How will are you going to protect your own earth, that your state? What can we do? What can we do about it? And make you understand how you, as engineers or scientists or doctors or activists, can really contribute to this small thing that we are trying to really do. You might be having a lot of people around. You might be on digital platforms. You might be tweeting. You might be writing on your Facebook page. You might be doing 110 different things on air that we are doing right now. But really, we need to focus on the ground reality. This was the bigger picture. These are some kids that I was working with. We had a wonderful session on streets. This was a session on streets. And these were random kids, not from fancy schools, not privileged enough to get anything fancy, but the sheer joy on their face. And I was making them understand something about global warming. And they had created a cyclone. Seriously, that is a cyclone there. That is how kids think a cyclone is. So yeah. Now, going back to what you have written, whatever you have written in the beginning, the word, one word. And one sentence. Yeah, can you just hold it? Can you just hold it on your screens? The one word and one sentence that you have so that I can quickly read. Yeah, social. Equality. Yes. That might have triggered here, okay? That might have triggered here. That might also have changed you in some ways. And you might be are working on the same. But I need you to understand how well you can express to our future, to our present, and what you can do about it. Because we are screwed up. Please accept it. And we need to change. Please accept it. But a bigger responsibility as YMCA or a society as whole, as member, individual members from your individual societies, please understand. You have to teach your future to make their future better. Don't be just selfish and think about your present. Okay, I'm just going to sit here and post videos and post content about the current situation, what's happening. Please, there is a reason that we have brains. There is a reason that we have a mouth and we have something that is touch. You can understand people, you can make them understand, you can educate, and you can educate through a lot of mediums, through music, through arts, through science, and through theater, of course. And yeah, hashtag touchscreen. I give you a hashtag to work upon, Frank. Yeah, so anybody, I'm done. I want to talk a lot more, but we have some time limitations here. So I would open up for some conversations, some questions.
Yeah, I have one question, I think. Can I go first?
Yeah, sure.
Right, in this time, right, we have now COVID, which is a pandemic, and people are scared, and a lot of people are, you know, affected, a lot of people are suffering, a lot of people have, you know, even lost their lives. So in a situation like this, I've been recently reading, and it says, like, even stress can reduce your immunity, right? So even just our workloads, our stress that we have in our heads will decrease our immunity and can make us, a potential victim, you know, to the ongoing factor. So what do you think, or how do you think, can art be practiced at home that could reduce stress?
I lost my aunt on 21st May. She was suffering from corona. And she was a Bharatanatyam dancer. That is Indian classical dance. So the point why I'm sharing is, there are a lot of stresses in your life, as Franklin just said, and it can really affect your immunity, and it can really affect whatever you're doing right now and whatever is happening. It can really create lot and lot of stress, and that can be a potential danger to your own self. Just think that you are working on okay, work from home, work for office, work from somewhere. Okay, you're working. But just take 5 to 15 minutes from your busy schedule. Okay, from your busy schedule, from doing nothing. Don't do anything. The problem is we are thinking, okay, if I'm not working, what should I do? Should I start to learn good music? Or should I watch a movie? Don't do anything. Just for 5 minutes, 15 minutes, in a day, just sit peacefully. The problem today that we are facing, a genuine problem that I want to reflect on, that we have too much too quick. Okay, I want a mobile. Okay, I'll get it online. I want this. I will get it online. It's on your fingers. And that, from that, you become restless. You even if you're not working, you're sitting at home, you want to do something. But just sit for a while with yourself. Just don't do anything. No hobbies, nothing. Don't read a book. Don't exercise. Don't eat a lot of food. Just don't watch Netflix. Just don't do anything. And just be there. I'm really damn sure you will find something. You will find something or the other in those 15 minutes. You will observe. You will notice. And you will experience. And these three things together makes one. O for observation, N for notice, and E for experience. Just do it for a while, and you will feel good. You will feel better. It's something that you just have to stay with yourself for a while to reflect on the society at large sometimes. Yes, anybody else?
Everything is in our hands, like YouTube. They can simply take a video and they can communicate the message what they have through mobile and everything. The mode is transformed like that. But in this case, in my opinion, whether the theatrical performance is not that much appreciated in India, or is it appreciated in India? What's your opinion?
Oh, that's a very big... like another seminar for that. But yeah, I'll make it quick and very short. Theatre is suffering in India. That's for sure. But yeah, it's not dying.
I completely agree with that.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not dying, okay? It's not dying. It's suffering, but it's not dying. So it's still alive. And if people like you who support, not only in India, but all over the world, I have, we as theater artists, I have spoken to a lot of theater artists all over Europe, all over the Pacific. I have some lovely friends in Fiji who are doing some lovely, in PNG, Papua New Guinea, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, everywhere arts is suffering. It's not theater is at particular, but arts is suffering. But yes, we are going to hit back, and it's important to for the community to watch something that is human and not virtual. I was doing theater way back for a summertime festival, and it was called Alice in Wonderland. So Alice, Chaotic Wonderland. It was on Don Quixote and Wonderland. And I had a kid. She was 6 years old, and she had come all the way from Hyderabad to Mumbai for her granny's summer vacation. And she watched a play, and which was on how good always wins over the evil. We had monsters and we had everything. That kid, she's still in touch with me. And she's still talking about that moment that she loved. And she always speaks the truth. And she says, no, Alice speaks the truth, so she is a good person. So I should speak the truth, so I will be a good person. And she is 12 years right now. I'm talking about a person who was 6 years back that I performed. And she's in touch. Her name is Sumaya, and she's from Hyderabad. And this is how arts and performing arts really, really, really help to develop personalities and help you grow. It's not noticeable. The change is not noticeable, but it's like, it's a very slow change. It grows in you naturally, and it grows in you gradually. So yeah, this is all that I wanted to say.
Perfect, Kiran. So guys, if you have any other questions.
Yeah, Akila.
Presentation by Kiran.
Yeah.
My question is there any, where, which country is this play originated? Is there any research regarding this continent, or some country may gain, this is our country's passion? Even in India also, we have different kinds of plays in related to different states. But I am asking overall, worldwide, is there any Europe or Asia or Africa?
Yeah, Kiran, sorry to interrupt. Professor Eglin, and also to all others, if you have your questions, please do drop it. I will get it answered with Kiran and then post it. We have, because we have 1 minute for the call to end, right?
1 minute,
yes. Yeah. So let me take it quick. Like, art started way back in the caveman's time, right? Man started painting, doing cave painting, and then dancing before the fire. So it's for all humankind, right? So let's all jump into arts, you know, enjoy ourselves, feel more stress-free, and then enjoy lives. Be good to one another, spread love. Thank you all. Thank you for a wonderful session, Kiran. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much.
A pleasure,
thank
yeah.
You so much.
Take care. Take care. Take care, everyone. Keep smiling.
Bye. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Namaste.